friends in the waters of baptism, our brother Alec died with Christ and rose with him in new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
Gather with his family, Maria, his wife, with Teresa and Callum and the extended family and all of his many, many friends and everybody who knew him and enjoyed his company. If I can maybe start by saying there are still a few seats in the chapel. If anybody is outside and wishes to come in and take a seat, I'd say there's a good maybe 20 to 30 places still available. And as we begin our service for Alec today, I spent a good bit of time looking through the many, many Facebook comments and posts about him, and many of them were from his life prior to being here on the island, and many of them, you just call him Ekrun, I think was what they called him most of the time, so that had to be said, I think, today as well, just it's lovely to see that he had so many friends, and so many colleagues, so many people who miss him terribly at this time. It was a very impressive march to the chapel with the various pipe bands bringing Alec to this place, this sanctuary for this Mass. So I just want to welcome as well and offer sympathy to the representatives of the various pipe bands and organisations who have made their way here today to say their final farewells to Alec, very much appreciated by his family. But we know that you're doing it because you have lost one of your own too. He was a big character within your organisations as well. And I know that those who were part of his army life too are missing him today. That's another family, isn't it? The whole army scene. And so he was part of the Black Watch, and he was a part of the Royal Highland Regiment, to which he gave 30 years of service. And for those who are with us online, and for those who have travelled, we offer our condolences to you at the passing of a brother at this time. And so I want to say just as well, just a word of thanks to Father Atto for his attention to the family since the word came through about Alec's passing. And he was the one that did all the legwork. I might be here today, but this was my first day that I was able to get in. But Father Atto did a lot of the legwork, a lot of the help, and I just want to say a tremendous thanks to him for that and for allowing me to offer this funeral Mass today. The family have chosen some gifts then that represent his life, and they're going to bring them to the table at the side of the coffin now, and Jerry Eyre is going to explain each one as they're brought forward.
So Callum is going to bring up his father's bagpipes. These bagpipes have travelled the world 10 times over, and I have to say they're probably the most robust, sturdy bagpipes ever made, because they fell more times, and I like playing with them, and I've seen them bagpipes actually being played as you lay on the floor, and any set of bagpipes and play Jingle Bells in July deserves a huge amount of respect. Maria is going to bring up his whiskey glass and cigarettes that I suppose went hand in hand with Alec. We all know he loved the dram and he loved Puff Puff, as he called it. And I often seen Alec, we all did. He could drink and smoke and talk at the same time. That was Alec. Teresa, his daughter, is going to bring up his wee alarm clock. This alarm clock was special to Alec. Never trusted modern technology. A clock all over the world now. And as we all know, Alec was always very early. Now, a lot of his bandmates here can't say the same thing. He often referred to Alex has gone too early. Donald, his brother, is going to bring up a very special photo of the Colin Kill band that Hunt and Alec were part of when they won the Worlds. It was a hugely proud moment for the Brennan family. But we all know the reason the Colin Kill band won was because the Armour band went and took that particular competition. And last but not least, his sister Hazel is going to bring forward his most prized possession, picture of himself, Maria, Teresa, and Callum. All the other possessions Alec had was nothing compared to family, a real family man, and that is to signify, I suppose, what Alec was about.
And friends for bringing up those and giving us a great flavour, a great part of Alec Brown's life and his loves and the things that they remembered about him, the things that made him who he was. And so they're there, and they're at the beginning of this service then. It's a reminder to us of the life that was Alec Brown. And so we begin today, and we start with our opening prayer for this funeral mass for Alec, after which we will have the readings. Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Alec, whom you have called to journey to you. And since he hoped and believed in you, grant that he may be led to our true homeland to delight in its everlasting joys. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please take a seat now and we listen to the reading chosen by Alec's family for today.
We also take out the first and the second reading. The readers.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The virtuous, though they die before their time, will find rest. Length of days is not what makes age honourable, nor number of years, the true measure of life. Understanding this, their grey hairs and tarnished life, this ripe old age. They have sought to please God, so God has loved them. As they were living among sinners, they have been taken up. They have been carried off so that evil may not warp their understanding or treachery seduce their soul. For the fascination of evil throws good things into the shade, and the whirlwind of desire corrupts a simple heart. Coming to perfection, in so short a while, they achieve long life. Their soul, being pleased to the Lord, has taken them quickly from the wickedness around them. Yet people look on, uncomprehending. It does not enter their heads that grave and mercy await the chosen of the Lord and the protection His holy ones. The word of the Lord.
God will save. Reading from St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, friends, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are yet alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out, and the command of the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be first to rise, and then those who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should find comfort in one another. A word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I'm going. Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
As we make our way through life, many of us, we find ourselves in different places, different parts of the world. This little island is a place where I remember going into any pub in my earlier years, and you could meet people and they would be talking about Nova Scotia, they'd be talking about all different parts of Europe, you'd be talking about all different places where they worked and lived. And so small places like this that maybe people have to leave to survive and then come back to is full of stories and full of experiences from all around the world. I always found the island not to be insular at all, but very much an island that could talk easily about its experiences throughout the world. And one of the things I've always noticed about people is that they always had a flavour. They always took something with them. It was always enjoyable listening to the stories that came back from all around the world. Some people told them with great aplomb, and some people told them nice and quietly. And it kind of reminded me that how different we all are. Not that one is better or worse than the other, but some people, if you quietly have time, they have a story to tell you. Others are going to tell you whether you like it or not. And that's what we're used to. I always think of the boats that come in and out from Bourton Port to here. And you see the likes of the ferry boats. They're big donkeys, I call them, big working boats, strong boats. They're built for a purpose, and they do make that purpose very well. But as they pass by, and I know this from being in a little boat myself, passing them, they throw you all over the place. The wake that they leave behind is incredible. It's just, it can be very, very violent at times. And then you see other boats, maybe a slender, beautiful yacht passing by quite quickly, and it barely ripples over the water. It has a way of skimming and dividing the water without making too much of a ripple behind it. And it made me think that that's the way we are. You know, we go through life and we leave a wake behind us. Every single one of us leaves a wake behind us. And for some people, we're slender, beautiful yachts, and other people are not. And I think as we come to say these few words about Alec Brown, he was not a slender, beautiful yacht. He was one of those gregarious characters who loved to see the choppy waters coming after him, who loved to make a difference when he went into a place, who loved to mix it up with people. He came to this island some 10 years ago. He was known before that, but he came to live here. And what a difference to this island he made. He wasn't off this stock, but that didn't matter because he had one of those rather large personalities and rather warm smiles that went through and passed by all the timid introductions that we might usually have to make as we learn to live alongside somebody else. That didn't apply when it came to Alec. He allowed that infectious personality, that large smile, and that energetic enthusiasm that he carried with him, he allowed that to carry him through. And anybody that was in his wake was pretty much sidelined by that. He didn't pass by quietly or gently. He passed by, and most people as he passed them by, went, "Whoa, that was a fairly good experience," and that we were glad that he did it, that he was there. Our island has become a better place because of these years that our friend Alec Brown stayed with them. We always had a proud tradition of piping on the island. It's something that we grew up with, something that we were very proud of, something that we saw a bit much like the sea as well. We saw it ebb and flow throughout the years, and but it was always there. It never disappeared, and it was always something that that was passed on from father to son to from and to daughter, and passed on beautifully. And so when Alec came here, he took that what was already there, the beautiful seeds of the beautiful traditions, the beautiful faith, and he lifted them. And he didn't take over. He just used that personality that he had to lift them and to begin to bring it to heights, dizzying heights at times, where they were able to do so much. As I said, listening through and looking at the Facebook, the posts about Alec, it was because everybody was so shocked at his sudden passing that they had a lot to say about him. But one of the things was the outpouring of great love for him that came from all arts and parts, from all organizations and from everybody that took the time to make a post. There was great affection shown toward him, and a great sadness that he had been taken from his family and taken from the island after such a short time and before his years maybe were filled. And it was that sadness was very, very apparent. But alongside that sadness came the fact that it was good that he passed by. It was good that his wake disturbed us. It is good that his wake maybe woke us out of the slumbers that we could be in, and it brought us to heights that we'd never expected that we could have. And so, as we gather for this funeral mass, we truly give thanks to the Lord for a very strong character, a very wonderful character, but one who tirelessly and without charge gave of his talent, his immense talent, and gave of his enthusiasm, and allowed it to rise the tides under all boats and bring people to places that they may never have thought of going to. I know the local pipe band found itself marching in different places because of the enthusiasm, the belief, and everything that he brought. And I know that he himself, as a piper, he never refused anybody if he was asked to pipe anywhere, which is probably who I know him better, is because he's been at this chapel quite often, and he was always outside. And he wore a ridiculously happy smile when he was there, making sure that he was doing his part to say farewell to an islander or somebody that was here. He never said no when he had the ability to be part of such things that happened in this life. I know too that I read Hugh Rogers' goodbye to him as well. And it was sad watching and seeing that Alec had been preparing the band members over the last year for a new program for the American Beaver Island trip. And he was telling that he received the itinerary from Beaver Island for the different events that the band would be playing at. And he sent on this information to Alec on the morning that he went. He was in Bangor, and Alec replied that he would have a look at it in the evening, that he was in Bangor at that time and taking a part in a competition. As Teresa, his daughter, said, he was doing exactly what he loved to do. He wasn't a man that wanted to linger and be sick. He wasn't a man who wanted to fade away. As Neil Young says, it's better to burn out than to fade away. And I think he was one of the ones that wanted the kind of exit that he had, painful as it is for his family. But it was on him that he was in his element. He had just given a perfect piping exposition out in Bangor, out in Newton Arts, and he had done what he does so well, and he was happy with what he did. And I think his brother was not too far away from him at that time too. And it was in the middle of all this that he was called. He was called away from this world and called away from this planet. We don't know the day, the hour. We're so aware of that at times. And I just thought that that goodbye and that those final words between himself and Hugh about the future, about what was going on, it was full of everything that he was about. It was getting the next thing organised, getting it out, but not just for him, but for everybody, and letting the wake that his boat passing by, let it lift all the boats and bring it somewhere new once again. So it was a sad day when we learnt about that, but there is something in looking to see that this man was stuck in the middle of what he loved whenever God called him. And instead of perhaps lingering, instead of perhaps being in a position of sickness and all of these things that we don't like to see happening either, he was called in the middle of what made him so happy. He was, first of all, a proud husband and father. He adored his family. They were his pride and joy. I think you edged out the pipes just a little bit in what he loved best in the world. And you were the ones that he lived for. He allowed you to explore the world with him. He brought you different places, from Hong Kong to Germany, to Scotland, and finally promising, as he did to Maria, that when he retired, that they would settle down here on this island in Arranmore. Everything this family did, they did together. He taught his children how to play the bagpipes until Callum went to the dark side and became a drummer instead. Despite his great disappointment at this, at having a drummer in the house, he was very, very proud of Callum and his achievements and of joining the competing Letterkenny pipe band. And he introduced his daughter Teresa to horses as a child, and something he thought she would grow out of, and how wrong he was. Secondly, he was a musician, and he was a grade one piper, and bagpipes were his morning, his noon, and his night. And his family tell me that by morning they meant very early in the morning, because it wasn't beyond him to start playing the bagpipes at 6 a.m., which anybody that knows how loud they can be knows that that would be a difficult moment in anybody's relationship. But he travelled the world with his music, and one could say that he enjoyed a wee dram everywhere in the world, including 50 of the American states. So that's quite an achievement as well. If that's for me, I'm not in, okay? So the other thing that I remember just reading online, and I thought it was lovely, was somebody was recounting about the celebrations after one of his achievements, and how they were all and this was maybe in Scotland with his music there, and how they all got together in a bar afterwards, and everybody got quite legless, is what they said. So, and that Alec was there, and he still had the pipes with him, and she noted that from the waist down he was as legless as everybody else. But from the waist up, he looked as if he was in a world-class competition playing the bagpipes, that he was able to bring his marvellous skill to play, even if half his body wasn't bringing him to where he wanted it to be. His promise was to Maria was to that after the travel and his army career, they would settle in Arranmore, a promise that he kept. His family loved him as a piper. He wasn't good at everything, they said. He was a failed potato planter. He was a questionable turf cutter. And he would hide from Donnelly if he seen him coming to check his bog. So he maybe knew that they weren't his best skills. And he was a DIY disaster as well, according to the family. I'm not making these statements on my own behalf. So, but he did turn his hand to everything. And during his 15 years of retirement, but the one thing that he loved was sharing his music with anyone who dared or cared to listen, and for that he will be forever remembered. He was kind, he was funny, he was caring, and he was generous. He had a smile for everyone. He didn't call anybody by their name. You were either son, hen, or pal. And he was a humble man who loved attention. That's a sort of a contradiction, but I think it suits all right, wasn't it? You know, it was. He was a humble man, but he did love the attention that his talents brought him. And his family are quite sure that he's looking down, smiling today about the fuss that is being made about him at this particular time. And finally, one of the things that was said, and I'm saying finally because I know that Tam is going to say a few words later on at the end of our service. But finally, one of the things that was said about him to the family that they found very comforting was that Alec lived three lifetimes in his one life. He may have been taken at an early age. He may have been taken before his full span of years. But what he did in those years was he lived three lifetimes. He gave of himself with a generosity that many of us just don't have possessed to give to others and to give to that. And he did it with a heart and a half. And that's why they chose that first reading that's saying it's not the length of your age that makes life honourable. It's not the number of years involved, but it's what you do in it. It's what you have achieved in it. And we know that you can walk away proudly knowing that Alec used these years to the absolute and utter best of his ability. Today we say our goodbyes to him. We ask God to take him home to his place. He wasn't a Christian with us, but he was a Christian alongside us. And Father Atto told me that because he married in a Catholic service, he said that he would have rubbed enough of it would have rubbed up off to help him to get to the places he needs to go now as well. So he can thank his family for that as well. So thank you, Father Atto, for your wise words there as well, and bringing a sense that God doesn't forget his own. There are many rooms in my Father's house. There are many rooms. There are many places that we can go and be there. And we have developed ways that are our ways, and they're good ways, but there are many rooms. The Lord does not turn away a generous and a loving heart. And I think that's what Alec brings with him as he makes his way to the afterlife. Eternal rest now grant upon him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. So we stand now and we offer the one thing that any of us can take with us, and that are our prayers, the prayers of the faithful. Heavenly Father, we ask you to be with us now as we offer these prayers. We offer them with a sense of happiness of what we have, of sadness because of what we've lost. So we ask you that as we offer these prayers, to take your son home and to bless his family in their grief today.
We pray for Alec and his parents, Thomas and Molly, that Alec be reunited with them in heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, please.
For all the people of Ardmore Island who have opened their homes and hearts to the family and friends of Alec, and who have made this day so special for all, may they be blessed abundantly. Lord, hear us.
Lord, please hear us.
We pray for all emergency services, including St John's Ambulance and all the first responders, for everything that they did for Alec on Saturday. We ask God to bless them in their work. Lord, hear us.
Lord, please hear us.
We pray for all those who have passed away. As we pray for Alec, let us remember the deceased members of the Brown and Kelly family, especially Frank McGregor, Alec's brother-in-law, who passed away on Wednesday. Lord, hear us.
Lord, please hear us.
to the pipers and drummers who've dedicated their time and talents in making this memorable send-off for our dear Alec. May they be rewarded for their kindness to him, Lord Ears.
Lord Jesus, take care.
We take a moment now just to offer our own prayers. Sometimes trying to put words on prayers is impossible, but that we do need to realize that the Holy Spirit can lift our unscripted prayers straight from our heart into the presence of the Lord. So we just allow the silence of this candle today to lift our prayers into his presence, knowing that he will hear and answer each one. Lord, hear us. Heavenly Father, these are our prayers, those spoken and those that lie deep within our hearts. We offer them to you in faith and confidence through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated now in the gifts we brought up during our offer for you. So, with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end, we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of your Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather the people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving due thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. And in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look with favor, look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and the blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect. Especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her husband, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Alan our Bishop, the other bishops of the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Alex, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with the Son in death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasant to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you are God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise him without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
Savior's command informed by divine preaching, we pray in the words that Jesus gave. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you. And let us offer to one another our sign of peace.
Thank you.
come, my call day. I'll put my pipes away on the shores of Arimor as the evening sun is setting and I look across the bay where I'll for her say and the tears begin to fall as I sing a reader of my love flowing hair has no glamour I declare and the roads I love to mar from but my heart is full of woe as today I have to go and the tears begin to flow as I sing a reader of your eyes are like the gleam of the sunrise o'er a stream and the song a fairy sings to the tune of pipers piping. My friends, please don't be sad. I'm proud, I make you glad, and I'll sail my boat as I sing the
O sacramento most holy, O sacramento divine, O
all praise and all thanksgiving here every morning night. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament of wine, praise and all thanksgiving here every morning night. Jesus Christ, I love you. All I have is yours. Yours I am, yours I want to be. Do with me whatever you wish. Jesus Christ, I love you. All I have is yours. Yours I am, yours I want to be. Do with me whatever you wish. Jesus Christ, I love you. All I have is yours. Yours I am, yours I want to be. Do with me whatever you wish.
Prayer of Communion. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Alec may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
We would ask you please to take a seat just once more, and Alec's family have asked Pam and Mum to say a few words on their behalf.
Well, I'll start this one just by saying friends, because that's what Alec was to everybody who came into his person. And I've given you just a wee brief insight to some of the things the Father described about Alec's journey. Alec's journey was defined for the early age of 11-year-old by music. We were a family of musicians and pipers in a very small community who I think we tried to best each other on the odd occasion. But Alec joined the local school band where I'd had my tutorship, and he quickly became a juvenile world champion. He was a man of excellence. And through that part, when we stayed in Lochore, we were a family of seven. Four girls, three boys. The boys kept the music. The girls, well, you had other things to do, looking after the family. But as Alec progressed into life, he left his school, and as the good father said, he tried several things that he thought he might have made a career of. There wasn't much success, I have to tell you that. But the one thing he could do was music. So he decided to join the army. And on this particular day, he arrived back at home, young man. Her father was still there, and he always addressed her father as Dad, and he kind of got that extension to his cadence in his speech. We kind of sat up. Dad, I'm going to join the army. I'm going to join the most famous Scottish regiment, the Black Watch. And my father left him with this shot. Yes, son, on you go. But mind, become a general. He just about made that. But his early career was defined by his piping career. He worked with some of the greatest pipers in his era. He went on to study at Edinburgh Castle, fulfilling tattoo engagements, the lone piper, basically all the jobs that happened, and he became senior instructor at Edinburgh Castle. And it was during this time that their dad had sadly passed by that time when Alec had fully developed this part of his career. And he arrived at my home, and I'm sure Maria will not mind. But he arrived at my home, and I'm known as Tam in the family. But when Alec addressed me as Tom, I used to have to sit up. So I'm sitting there with my wife, Janice. Tom. I said, yes, Alec. Need a word? I says, okay, Alec. I met a bra lassie, a beautiful woman. I said, oh, Alec. And he's standing up his heels. He had that wee thing where he rocked a wee bit, you know. I says, what's her name, Alec? He was getting all a bit nervous about it. Her name's Maria Kelly. There's a back story to this, but I'll keep it to the short story. Oh, I says, that's a lovely name, Alec. And where does this lassie stay? Oh, Edinburgh. I says, well, this is great news, Alec, that you're working in Edinburgh. He says, Tam, I want you to be my best man. Oh, you know, I think this was going someplace else. And suddenly this bolt came out, and I held the heart. I said, oh, brother, be honoured. I says, Alec, how long have you known this beautiful lassie? 2 weeks. But the essence of the story has then followed him through his life. When he set his sights on something to do it for himself or others, he always made it happen. And that followed him in his army career, and he finally had to leave his band, his Black Watch band work. And he was then promoted, probably the most promoted young guy ever to come through the pipe man world in the army. He then became a captain and promoted to a major, and he retired in that position. And then he came up to the next storyline was, we knew where he was wanting to be. When he first told me Aaron Moore, I thought, oh, that's fine, Alec. Aaron, a couple of hours in the car, we short ferry. He says, no, Tam, Aaron Moore in County Donegal. Oh, I says, right, so we Google mapped that one and found it was a fair old journey, Alec. But he had decided he'd been here before with Maria's mum and dad, Bert and Mary. And he arrived here. And I'll be honest with you, I have to tell you, this was the greatest thing that ever happened to him. As the father said, he's had a lot of time, a lot of lifetimes in a short space of time. But it was a new challenge, something that I think he was destined to be here at a time when Ireland maybe needed a lift, and I hope I'm not too presumptuous in saying that, because he started to tell me about things that were happening in the island and names of boys that he met, PJ, and nobody had a full name. I never knew anybody's surname, you know? And how much they had opened their hearts to welcome him, Joe Billy, Baby Joe, you know, and all these names, I'm in confusion. But eventually it became clear that they were defined by one or two, I would say surnames, Gallagher Boyle. I've seen the phone book once, Alex showed me that. But it was something that, it was right up his street. He was a people person. He loved the whole thrilly engaging. I always maintain if he went in an empty room, or sorry, a room with 20 people, he would empty it with 20 new friends. He had that whole mannerism and charisma. And as time moved on here, we've seen the rebirth of the band again. He told me about his trip to the Aviva Stadium. And I've got all these friends who are in the professional world of music saying, how did your brother wangle that one? I says, because he's that. See, that's how the guys got there. And that was a great highlight for him. But he moved on, and through that time I met people on the island, Andrew, Ellie, Jerry, so many of the people, who then the embracement started to work two ways. Everything he was wanting to do, they made sure it could happen, and they got a result of it as well. So he's always had a lifetime of community spirit. And I'm brightened by day because I see so many faces like Alec. No, it's a legacy. And if you ever want a story about Alec, he'll have tell you one. Rather than me tell you it and put arms and legs on it, you can smile when you remember the story he tell you. I leave you with this. I stand in the shadow of a giant.
Faucha Aruf Go Aramai. Glad to see you here. I know I spoke with Alex about four weeks today. I told him I would like him to come to be singing the church. And he promised me that, and I said, okay. August, we shall discuss that at least you should come, we begin to sing in the church during masses. He assured me of that. But I never knew that would be my last word with him. But however, I trust that as he has decided to go before all of us, the Lord will give him one of the pipes there, to keep on singing to his melodies and praises. And I believe as he has gone ahead, he'll be singing for all of us who live on the island, and also together he'll be singing with those, our brothers and sisters, who pass on, who are from here in God's kingdom. So I'd like to see this opportunity to thank my big brother in the ministry and great friend. But it's very hardly to, you know, to see him. You know, my big brother. I call him my boss. And for accepting to come over to preside over this funeral. Big brother, thanks very much. I hope you keep eye over me. Okay, he assured me of that. So once again, I want to thank all of you for making time to come over here to sympathize with us. As we turn back, I wish all of us a very safe trip back to our homes. Maybe for those who are seeing me for the first time, I'm the troubleshooter here. I make too much noise. Well, they said my name is John Atto, is the name, but properly, because so many Johns have been here, so they decided to keep to call me Father Atto. So that's my name. I'm the new guy on the block here, in charge of those I can make trouble with through my homilies. So once again, good to see you, and thanks very much for coming. I may like to say this in thank you again to the choir. But you look very, very scarce, and I think I've picked your faces already. So prepare for more troubles. We have to form a standing choir. I can see all of you are from the island here. So I think we'll have a discussion with you people so we can have a standing choir. So once again, thanks very much for the crash program, and thank you for making our worship more lively and spiritual. So as you return as well, I pray for God's wisdom and that he will give you a better voice to sing to his glory. Don't mind me, I talk too much. Once again, thank you.
Thank you. And as we finish, a word of thanks to Teresa, if I may, because you helped me a lot with in the last few days, just staying in contact and helping me to organize my part of this. Callum, we were fairly useless, I'm afraid, but that's all right. I'm sure you have other trades and gifts. But thank you for that. And we know that through all this and the lovely stories and stuff, it's a very sad day for you, and everybody's standing shoulder to shoulder with me here. And I know to the little pipe band here as well, I know the broken heart as well, having saying their farewells today. And I know that they must be at sea a little bit as well. But I think the 10 years you spent with you should give you, he believed in you, so keep going and keep doing what you do as the pipe band, both the pipe band, but especially his family as well. He believed in you. He knew each one of you beautifully. And I'm sure he didn't want to say goodbye. But I know that having gone, there's a little bit of him in each one of you, and that will carry you through and be with you always. Forever. So allow that to be our parting thought as we leave this chapel today. We now stand for our final commendation. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Alec Brown. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. And one day we shall joyfully greet him again with the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We spend a few moments in silence now praying for the repose of Alex.
receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May the angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and that perpetual light shine upon him. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Alec in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship. Merciful Lord, turn toward us, listen to our prayers. We ask you to open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us to remain. Comfort one another with the assurances of faith, until we are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace now, let us take Alec to his place of rest.
Thank you. Lord be reunited one day with our brother. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. Scripture tells us our true home is in heaven, and Jesus Christ who has returned we love to say a prayer passing over this place of heaven. O God, by whose mercy the faithful departed find rest, bless this grave and send your holy angel to watch over it. As we bury here the body of our brother Alec Brown, deliver his soul from every thought of sin, that he may rejoice in you and with your saints forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Our brother Alec from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last day. The family would like to place their tributes in the mercies. You raise the dead to life, give our brother eternal life. We pray to the Lord, Lord of mercy. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to those who mourn today for Alec, and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord, Lord of mercy. Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Alec Brown. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord, Lord of mercy. For all who are buried in this cemetery, may their suffering be lessened and their joy increased. May the light, Lord of mercy. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Loving God, from whom all life proceeds, and by whose hand the dead are raised again, though we are sinners, you wish always to hear us. Accept the prayers we offer in sadness for your servant. Deliver his soul from death, and number him among your saints. Clothe him with the robe of salvation, to enjoy forever the delights of your kingdom, through Christ our Lord. For his family we pray. Mary, God, you know the anguish of the sorrowful, attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in the everlasting goodness through Christ. The rosary here is prayed, as our tradition dictates. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. May the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her Son was dying, help those who mourn for Alec today, and accompany all of us in our sadness. May you rest in peace. May the soul of the souls of God, the dead, the martyr, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. May Almighty God bless us all.